As our relationship with technology evolves, how can humans and machines collaborate in ways that empower the workforce? There's no question that the demand for technology to support career development and other life changes is on the rise. 85% of people want technology to help define their future. 82% believe robots can support their careers better than a human. And 55% are more likely to stay with a company that uses AI to support their career growth. To talk more about the ever-changing relationship between humans and machines at work, I'm joined by Yvette Cameron, Senior Vice President of HCM Product Strategy at Oracle, and Dan Shawbell, Managing Partner at Workplace Intelligence. Thanks for being here. So I'm going to start with you, Dan. You are the co-author of the AI at Work Global Study. That explores the relationship between humans and technology at work. This is the fourth consecutive year of this report. How has our relationship with humans and machines evolved over the last 4 years?
Well, great question. So over the years, we've had an annual AI at Work study. This year was the biggest we've ever done. We interviewed 14,600 C-level executives, managers, employees, and HR leaders in 13 countries. And we're really trying to understand the relationship between humans and robots or AI in the workplace. But the when we say in the workplace, we really mean in our whole lives, because work has permeated our lives. People are working and living in the same place. And so what we found this year, much like last year, how we found that people are turning to AI and robots over humans when thinking about their mental health, this year, it's more along the lines of leaning more to technology when it comes to career-related decisions. So more and more every year, we're relying on technology to solve our problems in and out of the workplace.
You know, I just want to talk now to Yvette. I want to, you know, share with you some stats that I thought were pretty interesting. Research from the latest AI at Work study reveals that 85% of people want technology to help define their future, which is really interesting. 82% believe that robots can support their careers better than a human. That was really fascinating to me. And 55% are more likely to stay with a company that uses AI to support career growth. So Yvette, do these numbers surprise you?
No, those numbers really don't surprise me, because when we think about it, we're using AI technology every day. We're using it when we drive, when we cook, when we listen to music. So AI has really just become a natural part of how we engage. I think the use of AI, as Dan was saying, is pervasive. And especially now, as we are trying to overcome this last 18, 20 months of feeling disconnected, feeling confused about our futures at work, feeling disconnected from friends and family, wanting to come back to work, but looking for ways to overcome some of those barriers, it's only natural that we would want to turn to technology to help solve the problems that humans couldn't solve for us before.
The study also revealed that while employees are eager for change, they don't necessarily want to leave their current role. How can we give them that guidance so that they can stay in their career path in that current role despite all the challenges that they're dealing with?
Many individuals want to stay in their current career role. And in that case, right, ensuring that they have access to the training for reskilling and upskilling as their jobs change is really critical. But also, many individuals today are saying, I'm actually looking to leave, right? So the great resignation is here. I think it's fueled by the great awakening of all this frustration with lack of communication from their employers, lack of providing transparency and what skills do I need and what is my career path. I think that as we look to the future, we have to make sure that whether our employees want to stay in their current roles and grow as skills evolve, or they're looking to change jobs and find new career opportunities, this is an area where, again, technology is here and available today. And fortunately, people are used to using technology to meet other needs in their lives. And this is a perfect example of how you can use it in your career.
I want to also ask you, just as a follow-up then, and I'll have Dan actually add his insights after this, how are advances in AI supporting employees in their career goals specifically?
So at Oracle, for example, we have delivered in 2021 a new capability called Dynamic Skills. And the concept behind Dynamic Skills is to use deep learning engines, artificial intelligence, to scan and understand the skills of the global labor market, understand the relationships and connections between one skill and another, between a skill and a job title, and make the association and inferences of skills and job titles, and start applying that to individuals. So essentially, with artificial intelligence like Dynamic Skills, we can remove the friction from the process of connecting people with opportunities, and whether those opportunities are mentors or jobs or learning, removing the friction is what it's all about.
Dan, anything to add to that?
Yeah, I would love to add to that. In fact, one of the things that we ask year over year is, when examining the relationship between humans and robots in the workplace, is who's better at what, right? And because we look at this as more of a partnership, not as, you know, Terminator 3 or anything where robots are taking over and every job's going to be automated. No, you're going to have humans play a massive role in how they use this technology to, as Yvette was saying, make things more seamless, less friction, and more effective. And so when we think about the role that humans play, that robots can't really play, at least at this point in time, it's more about assessing someone's personality, understanding someone's strengths and weaknesses. And of course, it's about giving personal advice based on experience. You talk to a friend, you talk to a mentor, a sponsor, your manager, they're going to be able to give you more insights based on their career and what skills to select than you could potentially get from a machine at this point. But of course, machines, AI, and robots are extremely important because they can scale, they can give you the information in an unbiased way.
Yvette, back to you. I want to ask Oracle's point of view in the future of work and the role that technology plays, but how can technology truly empower the workforce?
I think when we think about the future of work, first off, we're experiencing the future of work today, right? The future of work that we imagined for the next 3 to 5 years hit us almost overnight when the pandemic came. We had to readjust, we had to rethink our approach to hybrid workforces, remote workers, really empowering individuals to bring their best to work and not being able to oversee their actions. It was really a change for individuals as well as organizations. As we look to the future, I would say that it's not entirely clear what the workforce will specifically be. And individuals, as I said earlier, have redefined success and are making new demands for their employers on what they are looking for as well as what they're willing to take. So I think in the future of work, we have to realize the power has shifted to individuals. And we have been saying as HR leaders that we need to put people at the center of our strategies, and that's never been more important now. If we want to be ready for the future, whatever the future holds, and I guarantee it will be flexible and more gig and contingent workers and less traditional employees, but whatever it brings, we need flexibility. And so Oracle, what we're doing is ensuring that our technology is putting people at the center, is fully configurable and extensible to the needs of organizations. So whatever strategies different organizations take, we're going to be there to support them.
I love that. I know that Dan has been long advocating for a more human-centered workforce, and I think that we're starting to see it. And sometimes you need to have a cataclysmic event like the pandemic to paradigm shift. Dan, I want to ask you if you have any predictions on what's next your study might reveal about how we feel about technology in the workplace.
I think where we're going in the future is people relying more on technology, not less, as it relates to every aspect of their life, right? The job they choose, the skills that they develop, for instance, getting help when they need as it relates to, you know, mental health, But I think the human skill set that's going to be needed as we move forward for leaders and employees alike is going to be adaptability.
Absolutely. Adaptability, flexibility, ability to be agile, I think will be really important, especially for leaders. But I don't even know if this would have ever been the future of work for it not been the pandemic. It would be a really rare event to imagine that all of a sudden every single company in the world would be remote on one day, you know, in March. And that has changed everything. It isn't just that we're in the future of work, we're in a whole different entire universe. And I think this, you know, kind of discussion is so important because it's the leading edge of what's possible. And that possibility around transformation is what makes me so excited. And you both are at the leading edge of that. And I just feel so privileged to having the chance to talk to you today. So thank you both for joining me.
Thank you.
Thank you.
As we've learned, the impacts of the pandemic, both personally and professionally, are ever evolving. The global workforce and their organizations are making big strides to regain control, set new priorities, and ensure that the future of work is supportive of everyone. Thanks for joining me each week for the AI at Work mini-series. I hope that you've felt less alone in your own struggles around the pandemic and are feeling hopeful about your own future.